Okay, let me start with our recap first. Okay. So in our previous classes, we discussed functions, right? In the functions, we discussed single row functions, okay, and group functions. After that, we also discussed about group by class. So in this, simple group by class and group by with group functions, group by with group functions, and group by with having class, having condition. And so in SQL, we all know that there are different types of commands like DDL commands. Okay, so that is data definition language. And DML, that is data manipulation language. And TCL, that is transactional control language. DQL, that is data query language. TCL, that is transactional control language. And DCL, that is data control language. Okay, this is basically it's a DBS job, but still I would like to give the overview of it. Okay, DBS activities. Fine. So in DDL, we know that we have like so many commands like create tables, right? Create tables and views, sequences, indexes, and alter tables, and drop tables. So we discussed about all these things: create tables and alter tables, drop tables. We actually discussed views, sequences, and indexes. And then the data manipulation language, we have like insert and update, delete, right? And in the data query language, like all the statements, whatever you are writing with the select. So in this again, we have like a simple select. Okay, and select with the columns and their aliases and joins. So in this, we have so many commands like equi join and non equi join. Okay, and outer join, and also self join, and using words, they are like inner join and left join and right join and full join. Okay. So then after this, we also discussed about functions. So those functions are again single row. These are all comes under like a select statement, or we can say DQL. So again, in this single row functions. So in single row functions, we have different functions, right? Like character functions and number functions. Number functions are, character functions are like upper, lower, length, substring, instring, and number functions are like sign, cost, and mode, okay, round, etc. And date functions, next day, months between, okay, those are all the date functions. Conversion functions, to cat, to number, etc. Then after this, we discussed about group by class, group functions. So the group functions are like sum and average, count, max, minimum, okay. And these are all the group functions. And we have discussed about group by class. So the group by class is basically what? To show only the unique records. If anything is repeated, either single column or combination of the columns, if the values are repeated, so those will be displayed as unique records. Okay. And the group by, again, simple group by, and group by with, you can use where condition, and group by with group functions, and group by with the having. Okay, so these are all we discussed in our previous classes. Okay, so still we have few topics in SQL. Okay, before we start PLSQL, so that's, let's continue. And yeah, so the next is the agenda for today is we are going to talk about TCL, transactional control language. Okay, transactional control language. So in the this is the agenda for today, transactional control language. So in transactional control language, we have commit and rollback, save file. Okay, so just let me give a chance to you all. If you have any questions or any doubts from the previous topics, just please go ahead from anyone. This is what we discussed so far. Okay, DDL commands, this creating new sequences, indexes, etc. we had to discuss, but creating tables, alter tables, drop tables, we discussed, and DML commands, inserting records, updating records, deleting records with different where conditions, using in, using not in, like, not like, between, not between, with all the different options we tried. And we also discussed about DQL commands, like simple select with different columns and their aliases, joins, functions, group by class. These topics we discussed, and we are going to discuss about TCL commands today. That's transactional control language. Any questions from anyone? Sanjay, Shiva, Suresh, Sakina, Deepak, Arjun Reddy, 1233.
I'm good, Gary.
Okay, perfect. So I'm hoping that everyone is clear on what topics we discussed and what is going to what topic we are going to discuss today. So TCL, okay. So let's start quickly with today's topic, transaction control language. That means you are going to control your transaction. So basically, first we should know what is transaction. What are the transactions in this? Anything that, like DML command, any DML command is called transaction. That means, what are the DML commands? Inserting, updating, deleting. These three are the data manipulation language commands. So it's a categorized, the commands are categorized like that. So the transaction means the data which is going to impact. I mean, when you update it, the data is going to change, right? When you are inserting, a new data is inserting in the table. When you're deleting, the data is, it's removed from the table. So those are the transactions. Now, how to control them? So we all know that what is commit and rollback, but there are some other things that we need to discuss. Some new things we should know, we have. So those we are going to talk about it. So basically commit is, it always saves unsaved data. Okay, unsaved data will be saved. For example, so we have this data. Now, this is the data we have. If you delete any record, or if you insert, or if you update, for example, EMP, set salary equal salary plus 5,000. So it's updated. That 5,000 will be added to all the employees, right? Select star from EMP. Now again, I'll remove one record, delete from EMP where, like EMP number equal 7934. Select star from EMP. So if you apply commit, this both the transactions will be saved, like the 5000 that we added and 7934, that record that we removed, right? So that will be deleted if I apply commit. That means one single commit will save all your transactions. It will save all your transactions. Similarly, if you apply rollback, it cancels all the transactions from the last commit point. That is very important. It cancels all the transactions from the last commit point. So this is basically saves all transactions. This is cancels all the transactions from the last commit point. So last commit point means, for example, okay, now let me update just rollback. Okay, I'll give just rollback because I don't want to save it. Okay, we'll go back. Now you can see the original data, whatever we were seeing initially, that data we are going to see. Okay, so now 5000 added, and the 14th record that was deleted, right? That is also came back. So both the transactions are cancelled because no commit point is applied. Okay, so now what I wanted to do is, okay, let's try again, update EMP, set salary equals salary plus 500. This is one transaction. So 500 will be added to all the employees. And also, okay, now here what I will do, here commit IRQ. So the 500 that we added, it is saved. Even if you exit and come back, you can see the data. Now, delete from EMP where EMP number equals, this is basically, it's a simple command. So one record is deleted. Now if you go back and see, that is deleted, right? We are seeing 13 records. Now if I give the roll back, so what will happen? We are saying from the last commit point, right? So last commit point is this. So that means from the last commit point, whatever the commands that you applied, DML commands, those will be rolled back. That means we have applied delete. So the record that we deleted, right? If you apply the rollback, only that record will come back, but there won't be any effect to this update because it's already updated and it's committed. So in the previous example, when I applied rollback, what happened? There is no commit point. So whatever updated, that is rollback, and whatever the record is that it deleted, that is also rollback, both, because no commit. But here commit is there after the update, so it won't affect the data that is added, the 500 that is added, it remains same. But this record, the record that we deleted can be rolled back because no commit applied. If you had applied commit, then you cannot roll back. Once it's committed, that's it. So if you have something, okay, this is not permanent job, I may roll back later after some time, then in that case, you need to make sure no commit is applied. But if you are thinking, okay, this is my permanent deletion, I want to delete it anyway, there is no use of this record, so I'm going to delete it permanently, then simply what you can do is just delete it and commit it. Now, this record may be in future again, I'm going to roll back. Then delete it, but don't commit it. As long as you are applying the other commands like select, you are seeing the deleted data. Okay, that record won't be available. But if you apply the rollback, that will come back. That means the delete command or update, it's doing temporarily. Once you apply commit, it's permanent. Once you apply rollback, just it's kind of undo. Okay, so this is fine. Now, what is save point? The save point is it won't roll back all the transactions. It is used to roll back from the specific transaction. It is used to roll back from the specific transaction. From the specific transactions means, okay. So this is our final data. It is already saved. Now I will update for job manager, I'll update some salary, and for salesman, I'll update some salary. For analyst, I'll update the salary. So the three update commands I'm going to update. Any either can do three same commands or different EML commands, that doesn't matter. So example, update EMP set salary equal salary plus 1000 where job equal to manager. So but before this, you can give a mark, you can just make it as this is save point one. Okay, just I'm marking the transaction that I'm going to write it, right? I'm marking it as example 0.1. So save point, let's give ABC, it won't take the number. So the save by name, you can give something like ABC or any name otherwise. Okay. So for example, this is my first transaction. What is the transaction? Is update EMP set salary equal salary plus 1000 where job equal to manager. Okay, so for managers, I'm adding 1000 to this. Update EMP set salary equal salary plus 1000 where job equal manager. Okay, three. This is A. Just I'm marking it's A. Transaction number one or transaction name A. Next, save point B. Next transaction. Update EMP set salary equal salary plus 500 where job equal salesman. That means I am going to add 500 to the salesmen, all the salesmen. Update EMP set salary equal salary plus 500 where job equal salesman. This is save point B. This is a B transaction. Just I am marking. You can say this a mark. You are giving a name to the transaction. Save point A means A transaction is this. B transaction is this. Okay. Save point C. Now update EMP set salary equals salary plus 200 where job equals clerk. Okay, update EMP set salary equals salary plus 200 where job equals clerk. Fine. So now A, B, C, three transactions are there. Now what I want is, I don't want to update the salary for salesman and clerk. Okay, managers is fine. Let it be 1000 salary. But I came to know that no salary is updated for salesman and clerk. If I give roll back, then what will happen? All these transactions will be canceled. 1000 that is added for managers, 500 added for salesmen, and 200 added for clerks. All the things will be canceled. But now the requirement is what? No, we don't want all from the salesman or from the clerk. So what we have to do is, in that case, I am assuming that everyone is clear on this concept. Roll back, save point. This topic that we are talking. Save point means First, you need to, before you apply a transaction, you need to give a name, same point one. Just you are marking that. Okay, you are giving a label to that transaction. Okay, A is updating managers, B is updating salesmen, C is updating clerks. Why this is required is, whenever you want to roll back to the specific point, that's what initially we was talking, right? When you want to roll back to the specific point, not all the transactions. Generally, if you give rollback, what happens? It cancels all, everything. A, that is 1000 added, B, that is 500 added. But now the requirement is, I want to cancel up to B only. Up to B means 500 added for salesmen, 200 added for clerks. Only that particular point, till that particular point, I want to cancel. So what we have to do is roll back to B. Okay. Rollback completed. Now you can assume that only the 1000 that is added, right? That will be there, all the managers, and remaining salaries for all the salesmen and clerks will be same. Okay, let's see. Start from EMP. So managers 9500. Now you can go back and you can see 8500. All the managers is added 1000. But we also added 500 to the salesmen, right? So example, if you see the salesmen, it was 6500. But now we'll see. It's same. It's not changed because we roll back to salesmen. Similarly, clerk, what was the salary for clerk? It was 3500, but what is now? Same. But if you would have applied only rollback, the manager salary that is added 500, right? That's 1000. That will also. So normal rollback is without any save point, it cancels all the transactions. Rollback to the save point, that means it will cancel. So up to that point from the last transaction. From the last means this is our last transaction. So what I have given, roll back to B. So B means what? Salesman. If I would have given C, only the clerk salary that is added 200 would have been cancelled. So that is all about save point and rollback. Questions?
It is similar to from, like when we say rollback to B, it means from B and whatever the numbers or the lines after B, it will be rollbacking those transactions.
Yeah, that's true. So that means you can think in the reverse way. Reverse way means roll back to B means from C to B, from the last transaction to wherever it finds B, right, up to that. So last means 200.
Okay, from last transaction.
The point which you have given. Correct. The point which you have given. So last transaction to B, yes. Okay. So let's go to the next topic. So this is all about the TCL commands, transaction control language. And now we'll discuss about views, sequences, and indexes. Back to DDL now. In the DDL commands, initially we discussed about tables with constraints, without constraints, and all the tables, drop tables, right? That's only the table part. But there are other tables also to create objects. So that's a views, sequences, and indexes are left. So we are going to discuss about that. Then after that, again, there are so many other comments such as we are going to discuss about the So now this is the time to discuss about view sequences and indexes. Because without having knowledge of all these things, or at least tables and the select statements, we cannot discuss about this. So now we all good how to write the select statement, how to write the update statement, how to write the delete statement, how to create the tables, how to alter tables, draw tables. So we are good to work with views and sequences. Okay. So let's focus on views first. These comments are not that complicated like group by and joins. They are really easy. The DDL commands we are going to talk about views. So view, what is view is? It's a mirror of the table. This is standard statement from the article, mirror of the table. So or you can say it's copy. Or it creates object. For the result of the select, this is technical statement. Okay, it creates an object for the result of the select. So that means, okay. So let me write the query also. Our syntax also here. See this syntax is this. Create or replace view. We have to give create or replace view. Generally, for table, what we do? Create table, right? But it's create, replace. Create or replace view. Replace means if the view is already exist, and if you are trying to create a view with the same name, that will be replaced. Okay. So create or replace view. Then view name as select. Whatever the select query that you write, right? So that will be your query. So it's an object, that's why we are writing create. That means it will be there in the database. Like a table, it will be there in the database. So what is the use of this view? I'll discuss. First, let's see how to create the view and what is view first. Then we will discuss about the benefits of the view. Because views are very useful to reduce, to improve the performance, you can say, and to reduce your time, jobs time. So there are so many benefits out there. Okay, so we are going to discuss about it now. Create or replace view name as select query. Okay, for example, so I want a table, or I want the result, or business wants the result that they don't want all this information all the time. They want department number, they want department name, and employee number, employee name, salary. That's it. Okay, that's the query that they want. So basically, what we will do is we'll write the query. Okay. That is select. Okay, let me start like this. First, we'll create a table. Create a view. Create or replace view. Create or replace view. Let me put employee view. This is a name. You can give any name. XYZ. Underscore V is also not mandatory. But just to identify by seeing that object name, you can identify V. V means it's a view. Okay, generally we'll follow some naming conventions, some standards in your company, in our project. Okay. So if you're creating a view, let's put underscore V. If you're creating a table, let's put underscore TBL. If you're creating a sequence, let's put underscore SET. If you're creating index, let's put underscore ID, something like that. So the standards, the company standards, we have to follow all the times. So they will share that what are the standards, because the standards are different company to company vary. So that's what first we should know, what are the standards the company is following. Okay, that we should know. So create or replace view name as, you can give any query. either you give select start from EMP, or if you want only few columns, EMP number, e-name, job from EMP, that's also fine. So this query, for this query, the view is created. That means a new object is created. Now if I give select start from employee B, right? So I can see only this start. Select start from, select start from means you have these three columns. Right? When you created a view, what happened? You have selected these three columns. So for that query, the view is created. If you see the describe employee V, okay, three columns are there. So this is a logical data. It's not physical data. So it won't take any memory. It's a logical data. So if you insert any new data in the employee table, it will reflect in the view. If you delete, it will reflect. If you update, it will reflect. Automatically, it will reflect in the view. So if you want entire table, create or replace view, employee, for example, I want managers, view separately. So create a replace view, employees, managers view, MGRV, you can give any view name as select star from EMP where job equal same manager. That means I'm going to create separate data for managers. So view created. Now you can see again, select star from this view name. You can take this view name. Okay, so there are three managers for this. If I do something here, update EMP set, salary equal to salary plus 200, wage job equal to manager. So what I'm updating here, EMP table. I'm going to update EMP table, but that will affect to the view also. So now we can go back and see employee. This view name you can take. See 500. We updated the employee table, but automatically it will reflect in the view. Again, it will also be reflected in the EMP. So creating view is simple, but what is the use of it? And I just for select statement, I created an object, but what is the use of it is, you no need to write the query again. And if you are building a complex query and collecting the data from multiple tables, okay, like so we have department and suppose you are writing a query to collect the data from the multiple tables, like they want department number, department name, and employee number, employee name, salary, where the department number is matched. Then what you will write generally? You write a query, right? Like select D dot department number, then D dot D name, D dot EMP number, D dot E name. Or for example, this data we want from department D, EMPE, where D dot department number equal E dot department number. So this is the query and output is coming. But you require this query again and again. Okay, you require this query again and again, and we want it to reuse it. So writing the query, and you cannot reuse that. If the query is like this, you cannot reuse it. You need to write the query again, entire query you don't need to write. If it's a simple query, that's not a big deal to rewrite it. But if it's a big query, big queries we are going to write, okay, for the project, we are going to join multiple tables, 3 tables, 4 tables, sometimes 5 tables, 10 tables. Okay. So you are going to write the query, but it's writing the query is not a matter, but I wanted to use it. I want to reuse it instead of writing the query again and again. So what you can do is simply you can write a statement like create or replace view. Okay, create or replace view. For example, I'll put a name, department EMPV, as this query I'll take. Okay, create or replace view, view name as yourself. So view created. Now any developer, no need to write this query. Whenever they want this information, simply what they will do, just they will write select star from a DEPT and EMP view, that view. So they no need to write the query again. For example, our this data frequently we are pulling. So do I need to write the query again and again? No, not required now. Similarly, you can have those kind of queries ready and you can use it. So for the reporting purpose, so manager's wise data if you want, you can have a separate view. And clerk's wise data if you have, you can have a separate view. Alright, you're joining multiple tables and frequently you are going to get the data, you can have it. And another thing is it will update automatically. If you apply the base table, it will be reflected in the view. That means if you change the department name, it will update here. I mean, because this query is running, what is happening is whenever you apply this statement, right, behind this, what is there? Behind this query. So that query is running. So, but what the query is doing, it is taking the data from the base tables. The department and the EMP are the base tables, is taking the data from the base table and executing the query. So the benefit is whenever you want to reuse, okay, and similar requirement or similar report you are generating again and again, so it's very difficult to write the query all the times. So instead of that, you can have a view, write it, use it. That's it makes sense for any questions. So in our project, most of the time you will see the views. You'll see the views. Because the data is collected from different tables. It's not only from a single table. And whenever you are applying developing an application, okay, so you will be pulling the information from the different tables and you are showing it. So behind that, what you have to do is you need to write a query and create view. So behind that view will be there, that will be executed. So I can use it. You don't need to join all the times, you don't need to apply the main condition, you don't need to think it again and again. Just you can reuse it. So to make your job easy. Okay, from Deepak, just it happened to see your message. Just okay, I want to roll back only B, not C. It's not possible, Deepak. There is no option. You cannot do like that. So you can write a program, BLSQL program, but with the rollback command, that is no option. That kind of command is not there. So rollback to B means B and C will be rollback. Rollback to C means only the C will be rollback. Okay, perfect. So any questions from views?
Ganesh, with view we can only use select statements, right? Just right. To create the view table, the view of the table.
Yes.
Right? And in application also, we see view table. So the those are also same as it is created here, right? As you have shown.
Yeah, right? Yes, that's correct. So you can build views. Yeah, for example, I would like to create another view, department wise count, department wise employees. So create or replace. View emp count p as select, what should I do, d dot department number comma d dot d name, I want count, then count dot star, I'll write as select d dot number. Then d from department d empp where d dot department number equal e dot department number, the join condition is common, group by, right, we have to give group by d dot department number comma d dot d name. Must name this expression with a column alias. Okay, for count, the column alias is required because they are creating the view, right? So that's good. If you are running directly without view, that's fine, it will work. But if you are creating a view for the function, you need to give alias. Now select star from empty count. So anytime you want the count of employees, because the count will be changed, right? Department wise, new employees will be added or existing employees will be eliminated. So whenever you want that output, simply you need to apply this view. That's it. So you don't need to think and write the query, rewrite the query. So this kind of queries that we run if frequently, so we'll maintain the dictionary and we'll use that. I mean, we'll maintain the track based on the frequently used queries, we'll create the views and we'll use them again and again. So that saves our job, saves our time, a lot of time will be saved with that. And it will helpful to the users also, because users don't know how to write the queries. So you need to prepare a view and give it to them. Simply they will run that query. Just the basic knowledge they will have like this. Or in the application, you will have a button. Click there, show the data. So when you click show count of employees in each department, that's query behind that button we will have, that view. So the view will be displayed there. So for the end users, we'll prepare some queries and we'll use them in the application. So end user will click on a button, we'll show the output because they don't know how to write the queries. They cannot write the queries also because they don't have access to the database. So in many ways, it will help.
Anish, one more question. If I delete any record from the view, will it be get deleted from the base table, or it will only?
Actually, that is very good question. First thing is, if for example this table, right? This is combined. I mean, the data is we have joined here, department number equal to your department number, right? The straightforward answer is if your view is allowed to delete, yes, it will be deleted from the base table. For example,
so in this view we don't have access to delete record, or we don't have the permission to delete record, something like that.
Yeah, generally we don't give the permission. We'll give only the read-only view, read-only access to the users. We don't give the delete permissions. Okay, then how to give the permissions, we discuss in the DCL commands. The data control language is pending, right? Grant, revoke, and etc. So there we are going to discuss about how to give the privileges on the table to update, to give the to provide permissions to update, delete, or only read-only access you want, like that. So we created a view, right? Like, what's that view? Okay. So yeah, I'll come to your question. For example, this is the view. This view is created with two tables, right? By joining two tables. Right, Sanjay, you agree with that, right? This view is created by joining two tables.
Yes.
Now, if you try to remove this particular record, department number 10, it won't allow, because assume that if you try to remove the department 10 from the base table, department table, do you think it will allow? Are you sure it will allow or not? If I remove the department number 10 from the department table, will allow your SQL will allow or not?
It will allow, I think, from the base table. Because it's an independent. No. Oh, no, it's a okay.
It won't allow because
independent.
Employee table is dependent on that, right? So it won't allow. It won't allow because it's a master detail. Primary and foreign key concept is there. If you want to remove department 10 from the department table, first you need to remove all the employees belongs to the department 10 from the employee table. And commit it and go back to the department table and remove it. The same logic is applied in the view also. We also doing same job basically. So it checks, okay, if you are trying to remove the department 10 from the view, so it always look at the base table. Okay, it is trying to remove from the base table, department 10, but foreign key is there. So it will be an error. You agree, right?
I agree.
Yeah. So the same concept here also. That means is it just on the screen it looks like a view, but internally what is happening is view, the query is there, right? It is going to that query and looking at that query, what is there in the query. So what is there in the query? Department D table is there. So if you are trying to remove this department number 10 from the department table, but your query will be, your statement will be, statement will give you an error. Statement is correct. If you write delete from this table, this view, delete from EMP count V, where department number equal 10, the statement is correct, but since it has master detail relation, it won't remove, it won't allow. Even from the base table, if your base table is allowing, your view will allow. If your base table is not allowing, means if you think that, okay, my base table, if I try to remove the record from the base table, it won't allow, means yes, your view also will not allow. Because the view also created based on the base table, right? So that's why it looks like a view, but behind that view, the query is created, or queries we developed using the base table. So that is why in some scenarios, yes, it will be deleted, but in some scenarios, it cannot be deleted because it cannot be deleted because it has a master detail relation. It can be deleted if there is an independent table. That's it. EMP table, for example, I created a view. Okay, create view. Create or replace view. Some name I will give, etc. As select star from EMP. Okay, this name is already there. You can remove it. Drop view. Etc. If you want There are some restrictions on that. Create variable tnb as create or replace new tnpb as select star from tnp mp. Okay, now star from tnp and select star from tnpb. Okay, now both are set. Now I'll try to remove a record from the view. Delete from TMPV where EMP number equal 7934. So what do you think, Sanjay? It will remove or not?
It should, right? It's
yes. It should.
The child table,
because in EMP table there is no dependence. No other table is dependent on this EMP. So EMP is, you can remove from the EMP table. So it's deleted. Now you should go back and see the view it's not there. Even in the base table also it won't be there. Got it, right?
Yes, clear. Thank you.
Yeah.
Ganesh, if we have to update, you know, a few tables, can we, I know view is only read only, but can we update a few tables from this command using the create or replace? Yeah. Can we insert, I mean, update, you know, at the same time, or you just read only?
Only read. You cannot update. I mean, your question is like, can we update, can we apply update command and view? That's your question.
Yeah, can we look at the, you know, the table? I mean, can we use this command to, you know, just view both the tables or whatever?
Yes. Update, delete, all the things. Just now we discussed about delete, right? Delete, we apply. Similarly, you can apply the update also. For example, update TMPV. Set salary equals salary plus 200. It will update both the tables. Update TMP B. Set salary equals salary plus 200. So update and view, right? Now, if I see the data in both view and table, you can see same values. It's updated. 200 is added now. Same data. If you apply update view, it will also update the base table.
Okay, thank you. And so this is much easier to, you know, it's much simple process to do an update and, you know, auto delete or not. I know it's, you know, it's not that easy, but definitely update. It's a good option to be.
Yeah. But another important point here is in the real time, in the real time in your project, updating, deleting, inserting in view is not recommended. Updating, deleting, inserting is absolutely we have to do at the base table. Okay.
So Ganesh, is there a way we can, you know, take this information, like, you know, whatever we want, like, you know, to find out, you know, to collect the data and then to analyze it? Can we do it in a separate? Can we create like a duplicate record and to create, you know, the same like a mirror, onto?
Yeah. Yes. Using you can do it. That's what we are doing. Yes.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, and yeah, we have sequences and indexes. The sequences and indexes we will discuss tomorrow. Okay, for today it's enough because we discussed TCL commands and how to create views. So tomorrow we discuss sequences and indexes. Then we will discuss about some more commands are there, like EOD and union all intersect indexes. So another few more sessions, 3 or 4 sessions, I think. I need to see the syllabus also. I think I hope everyone has received the notes. Or still waiting?
Yeah, we are still waiting. I'm still waiting. So I have, I don't even have a single copy. So I have spoken to them. Call them again.
Okay. Did you send a mail to them saying that please share all the notes that we discussed in the class, something like that, or?
Yeah, I did, and they did send me the, you know, the access to the instance, but it's of no use if I don't have, you know, I'm going to call them.
Okay. Because I shared all the notes as of till our last class, whatever we discussed. So, okay, I will also have a word because last few days I was a bit busy, so definitely. Even I'm sending mails half to the class, every class. Okay, and then checking them. See, this is not class 9, 10, class 11. And before that, I already shared all the notes. To share notes to all the person. All these documents I already shared. Okay, so it's better if you can have them and go ahead with them. Okay, anyway, I'll talk to them. I will talk to them today and make sure.
Okay, that'll be good.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any questions? Any doubts? Okay, then, if no questions, I think we can wind up the session. Okay, thanks for joining. And let's have the next session at
the
same time. Okay.
Thank you, Ganesh.
Thanks, Ganesh.
Sanjay?
Yeah, tell him. Yes.
I remember the last class you were saying something, but before that only I just clicked on that exit button. Before just exiting, I heard.
Okay, no, I have to recall that. Yes, I just forgot.
Okay, that's fine. No worries. Okay.
In the next class, if I get, I'll just surely I'll ask you.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. Thank you all. Bye.